Amateur Theatre, this is Group Therapy 250.
What an incredible place. Welcome to ABGT 250. It's my pleasure to welcome the first act of the evening, a man with a moustache just as awesome as his music. Please give it up for Luttrell.
I don't know about you guys, but when we started this radio show all those years ago at Ministry of Sound in London, fueled by a cheeky Nando's and a couple of beers, I never thought it would turn into a two-day event with 25,000 people in attendance. Welcome, my furry friends, to Group Therapy Gone Large, broadcasting to you live from the beautiful Gorge Amphitheatre in Washington State. As the sign on the roof of this very studio says, we're on air across a multitude of FM and satellite radio stations across the globe, streaming via Twitter live here in the US and a number of other video services worldwide. Thanks for joining us.
Yeah, there's definitely a global feel to tonight's show, and that's true of our lineup as well. San Francisco's finest, Eric Luttrell, is currently on stage. His star has been on the rise over the last 18 months with a series of awesome deep house and techno tracks, and a rather epic start to his set tonight as well. He'll be followed by my fellow Finn Otto Ylipertola at 7 p.m. local time, maybe better known to you and me as Yotto. Following an incredible set at the Ziggo Dome last year, it's great to have him back as part of this year's ABGT show.
Yeah, definitely. There's a brand new EP from Yotto coming out in a few weeks, so I'm really looking forward to hearing more of that tonight. Third on stage will be a rather special moment for us all, as Anjuna Beats' original, in fact, I think he was the first ever signing to Anjuna Beats, and one of our oldest friends, Oliver Smith, finally makes his long-awaited broadcast debut. His music's just so exciting and innovative at the moment, and I can't wait to hear some of those new tunes out live for the first time. At 9 p.m. local time, it's the first of two back-to-back sets tonight, as the UK and Hungary combine. For many years now, Genix and Sunny Lax have been filling our sets with some stunning melodic music, so we give them an hour tonight to show us what they can do.
At 10 o'clock, it's time for some group therapy with Above and Beyond. Freshly baked Anjuna kitchen treats aplenty over the 2 hours, including brand new music from the Gabriel and Dresden album, the new Ilan Bluestone Scars album, and lots of new bits from us as well.
Should be a lot of fun, that, as well as the final hour of tonight's broadcast with local lad Seven Lions going back to back for the very first time with Jason Ross. That's going to be interesting.
Yeah, can't wait. So also on the way, we've got news and views from all of you guys tuning in at home as well. Info on how you can be part of this very radio broadcast. But for now, let's get back to that wonderful music. This is ABGT 250, and live on stage is Luttrell. We'll be right back.
live from the roof of our radio studio on the edge of the gorge. I'm joined up here by various members of our Anduna HQ Massive. You can see Beaverly beavering away in the background there. Their job is to go through the messages which you're sending in via Twitter or other means. If you want to stay in on the conversation, don't forget our all-important handbag, ABGT, which is being ably modelled by Duncan over here. That's a bit lame this year. We had a handbag last year. We'll also be having some guests up here later on, and the sunset will be happening very soon, although we can't really see that much of it. But for now, let's get back to the main stage and Luttrell.
You're tuned to Group Therapy 250 with Above and Beyond, live from the gorgeous Gorge Amphitheatre in Washington State, about 3 hours' drive outside of Seattle. Latrell is currently rocking the main stage. He's a great DJ, and he's delivered some amazing records over the last 18 months, including Need You and Generate. It is so great to have him on one of our milestone shows. Tony, I understand you had a little bit of a chat with him yesterday.
I certainly did, Jono, and you can see that interview in about 10 minutes' time. We were sitting at the top of the hill, and it was empty yesterday. It's amazing to see this venue filling up with fans that have travelled from all around the world to be here. Our global group therapy event seems to get bigger every year. From Bangalore to London to Madison Square Garden, the Allphones Arena in Sydney and Amsterdam's Ziggodome. I don't think we ever dreamed, though, that this would become a two-day camping event. But there's 25,000 people here proving us wrong. And what a stunning location and sunset as well.
I absolutely agree. People have been arriving to camp here since yesterday morning, and there's been countless RVs and cars pulling onto site over the last 24 hours. We even had a little movie screening here last night with the help of our friends at T-Mobile. It was the world premiere of Above and Beyond Acoustic live at the Hollywood Bowl, the forthcoming full concert film which captured that amazing night under the stars. It was directed by Paul Dugdale, who's worked with the likes of Ed Sheeran and the Rolling Stones. And what he did, he really did make it look rather epic. So thanks, Paul, for that. There's also a documentary film directed by our long-term collaborator, the guy behind Small Moments video, for example, a guy called Miles Desenberg, which gives you an insight onto a life or onto the life on the road during last year's acoustic adventures. We're certainly thankful for being able to turn our musical passion into our life like that. And the title of the film, Giving Up the Day Job, reflects just that. We'll be doing cinema screenings of the film in November, so keep an eye out for more info on that. And we'll also be releasing the live audio from the Hollywood Bowl, so you can relive Above and Beyond Acoustic all over again.
Yeah, I thought the response last night to the screening was great, didn't you?
Yeah, it was lovely.
Yeah, everyone was in great spirits, and I saw a lot of onesies, pyjamas and all sorts. There was a great energy out there, and I'm sure it will continue throughout the weekend, especially with tomorrow's Anjuna Deep celebrations. You're going to be able to watch that online as well, and it's going to feature this man, Latrell, going back-to-back with Yotto. But let's see what records he's got in his box for his solo set tonight as we send you back to the stage.
Hello, it's Tony again, continuing our tour of our broadcast facility. I've come outside the studio. I'm walking you, notice the beautiful sunset behind me, to where some of the people who make this happen work in a little hut here. I'm talking about our video team. Say hello, video team. I'm going to be putting those people to work now with an interview that I filmed yesterday at the top of the hill there with Latrell. We started off by asking him how he got onto Anjuna Deep. QVT.
So actually through Matt Zo, we were down there because he put out the M Machine record and we were down in LA and just kind of going over the whole thing. And I was like, hey man, I've got like some more like deep house and melodic techno stuff that I'm working on, and I showed it to him. He's like, oh dude, just send this to Juna Deep, and you know, James and all them probably would be into it, and just kind of snowballed from there. And you know, year and a half later, here we are.
So tell us a little bit about the new music that we're going to be able to hear from you, from your set. So you're playing on the main stage and you're doing back to back with Yotto on Sunday.
Yeah, so tomorrow on the main stage, I'll be playing at least two new ones. And one is called Contact. That'll be the new single, which is releasing in October. That's a vocal track, so that should be fun. And there's another one called What You Are that's more of like a progressive deep house track. So yeah, that'll be cool. And then with Otto, I'll play a few of the more banging tracks that I'm working on. So
that was Eric Latrell and myself talking yesterday at the top of the hill over there. We'll have a post-gig debrief with him after his set. But now, let's have something nice on screen. Not me, let's go to the drone cam. We'll be right back.
Hey, gorgeous people! What do you make of that? Please show your appreciation for not only the finest moustache in dance music, but also one hell of a producer, Eric Luttrell!